So the next one, find the points on the curve x square by 9 plus y square by 16 is equal to 1 at which the tangents are first one parallel to x axis and the second one parallel to y axis. So we will take the curve x square by 9 plus y square by 16 is equal to 1. As usual, differentiate. So 1 by 9 is a constant, derivative of x square is 2x plus 1 by 16 is a constant, derivative of y square is 2y into dy by dx. Equal to 1 is a constant, derivative is 0. So take this term to the right side. So what we get, 2y divided by 16 into dy by dx equal to minus 2x by 9. We need only dy by dx. So dy by dx equal to minus 2x by 9. Actually, we have to divide the right side with the 2y by 16. Instead of that, what we can do, take the reciprocal and multiply. So we can multiply with the 16 by 2y. 2 get cancelled, giving you the value of dy by dx as minus 16x by y. Okay, and there are two parts for the question. The first part is parallel to y axis. We have to find the point when it is parallel to x axis, the first part, and parallel to y axis, the second part. Parallel to x axis, we will deal with the first one. First one is parallel to x axis. If it is parallel to x axis, what about the slope? The slope will be equal to 0. Isn't it? Slope will be equal to 0. That is dy by dx equal to 0. Which implies minus 16x divided by 9y. 9y is equal to 0. Which implies x equal to 0. So we got the x coordinate as 0. To find the y coordinate, what we will do, substitute the value of x as 0 in the given equation. Given equation is x square by 9 plus y square by 16 equal to 1. Can you identify which is this equation, which is a curve? It's an ellipse, isn't it? So if you put the value of x as 0, what we get? 0 plus 0 by 9 is 0. Y square by 16 is equal to 1. That is y square is equal to 16, which gives you y as plus or minus 4. Okay, so which are the points? In the first case, the points are x coordinate is 0, so y coordinate can take two values, plus 4 and minus 4. So one of the point is 0, 4 and the other point is 0, minus 4. When it is parallel to x axis. And in the second case, what is the second part? Second part is parallel to y axis. When the line is parallel to y axis, actually, the slope is not defined, isn't it? So what we will do is, if the slope is not defined, 1 by 0 is the case where it is not, we are saying that it is not defined. That means slope of the tangent is not defined. Its reciprocal will be slope of the normal. 1 by 0 is not defined. Okay, that means minus 1 by dy by dx, that is the slope of the normal, that will be equal to 0. Clear? Normal's slope will be equal to 0. Okay, so we are taking this condition, minus 1 by dy by dx equal to 0. And don't cross multiply. Instead of cross multiplying, what we will do is, minus 1 by dy by dx can be written as minus dx by dy equal to 0. Okay, so that dx by dy is equal to 0. What is dy by dx? Dy by dx is minus 16x by 9y. So dx by dy will be the reciprocal of this. So what we are getting is minus 9y divided by 16x is equal to 0. Which implies, again we cross multiply, minus 9y is equal to 0. Again implies y is equal to 0. So we are getting y as 0. If y is equal to 0, if we take the equation x square by 9 plus y square by 16 is equal to 1, we are getting x square by 9 is equal to 1. This terms become 0. X square by 9 equal to 1 implies x square is equal to 9. And that implies x equal to plus or minus 3. Okay, so which will be the points? X is taking two values, plus 3 and minus 3. Y is taking the value 0. So the points will be 3, 0. X coordinate is 3, y coordinate is 0, and the second point is minus 3, 0. Okay, so don't forget about the condition. When it is parallel to x axis, we will take slope as 0. When it is parallel to y axis, we have to take dx by dy equal to 0. Otherwise, remember like this, when it is parallel to x axis, dy by dx will be equal to 0. And when it is parallel to y axis, dx by dy equal to 0. Actually, the slope is not defined. That is the reason why we are taking the slope of the normal. Okay.